What mass of copper would coat the cathode from a solution of copper to sulfate? What mass of copper would coat the cathode from a solution of copper to sulfate? When a current of 5 amperes is passed through the solution for 2 hours. For 2 hours.
Ile Q is equals to IT, time equals in seconds.
Yes, time is always in seconds. So it means you multiply 2 hours by 600. This information is given, additional information, Cu is always 63.5, and then 1 Faraday is given by 96,500 kilo. Now, you have to write the ionic equation for copper, that is C2, 2 plus, plus 2 iota, they give you copper solute. That is Cu, 2 plus aqueous, plus 2 electrons, it's going to gain 2 electrons to become copper. So you have 2 moles of electrons, which is 2 moles of electrons, which is equivalent to 1 or 2 Faraday, which is equivalent to 1 mole, which is 63.5 grams of Cu solid. Now, what happens? 2 moles of electrons equivalent to 2 Faraday will deposit 63.5 grams. Now, can you get the quantity of electricity there? That is IT, which is 5 times 2 times 3600 to change it into seconds. You are going to get 36,000 kilos. Isn't it? It's 5 amperes.
3600.
Yeah. See, 60 plus 60. 60 times 60. There. See, 60 times 2 is minutes, then you multiply by 60 times. That is at kilograms. Next. So, to deposit 1 mole, which is equivalent to 63.5 grams, you require 2 Faraday. And 2 Faraday is 2 times 96,500. 96,500. 96,500. Which is equivalent to 63.5 kilo. What do you get here?
193,000
kilos is equivalent to 63.5. Then
what about 36,000?
Implies that 36,000 63.5 over 193,000. What do you get?
11.845.
See?
11.845.
Let's
make it into 4.
Lazima? Now, that is one way. Another way you can get the moles. Moles, you have been given. You have been given what? You have been given 63. 63. Can you get moles? We can say 190 what? 193. 1,000 is equivalent to 1 mole. It's So 36,000 is how many moles? That one will give you 36,000 over 193,000. What is the number of moles?
0.18 65
more. Now you want the gram deposit. If 1 mole can deposit 63.5, then 0.1865 moles will deposit how many grams? Replace that 0.1865 times 63.5 over 1. So we give you
11.8427
grams. Approximately 11.8 grams. Next.